everybody. Welcome to Stinky and Bunny Online. I'm a host, Stinky, and right over there is Bunny. Bunny.
Hello, it's me, Bunny. I did it.
Hey, Bunny, how's it going today?
Today, this day, so good.
Oh, what's good about it?
I mean, you know.
Oh, fair enough. All right, should we have one of these?
Oh, we should. I already got mine mixed up. I don't know why you take so long. I got mine ready.
Oh, geez. You know what? This is going to be an interesting top of the show right now.
Is it?
Yeah, you know
why? What's going on? What's going on your side of the RV?
I forgot something today.
What'd you forget?
My ukulele.
Ah! Oh. You mean we won't get to do our opening theme song?
We'll do it. I'm gonna find a way here. Fill some time. Yeah. Talk to the people. I'll be right back.
Hello, people out there watching the show from your Twitters and your Facebooks and your Periscopes on your submarines. If you're out there in the world, go ahead and hit the chats and tell us you're alive and that you're doing well. Tell us what you want from this show tonight specifically. And if you're not out there in the chats, then get in the chats. I don't know how we're going to get to you, but somebody, if you have a friend who's not in the chats, chat to them and see if the chat will get to them. I think it works like a raven, where if you like send it out, it finds them. But do it, you know, do it. Just get in here and join our Patreon. That's right. If you sign up with Patreon right now, you could make it into the VIP after party.
That is true. That is very true. Hey, thanks for filling in some time. Hey, there we go. We got cheers, by the way. Cheers.
Cheers.
I see Jake's out there. He's got himself a drink there. Mike Chapman is very disappointed about the ukulele situation. We have Kerslixlov again.
Kerslixlov. I love Kerslixlov.
Oh, that's good. Here we go. I got a substitute instrument.
Ooh, Marcus.
Ready for this?
Oh, yeah.
I'm Stinky.
I'm Bunny. And we are really funny. And this is our show.
Season two.
Oh, wait.
Oh. I don't know. That was almost better.
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah, for sure. Well, hey, everybody. You know what? I'm going to type in the chats right now. We've announced this over the last couple of weeks, but it's coming up. Holy moly, it's coming up. Friday, Saturday, Sunday, this weekend. You can catch us at a Perro show, which is at Town Square in Las Vegas, Nevada.
That's right. I'm gonna type in
here, right, where to get the www.apparelshow.com. You can go there, go to that website there. You can grab yourself a ticket. It's limited because of, you know, everything's limited nowadays. So make sure you get in there and see us in the show, and maybe you can hang out and say hi afterwards. We'd love to see you. We'd love to chat with you. It's always good to meet people.
Oh yeah. Get out there, right? See that show. It's a big time deal for us. We're gonna be live on stage.
Yeah, we haven't been live on stage in a long time.
That's true.
It's going to be fresh.
It's going to be fresh.
Very fresh. Very fresh. All right. You know what? We got some people we're meeting today.
No way.
Yeah. Do you want me to list them here?
Oh, I want to know what humans are on the show. Yes, please.
Yeah. We've got a Darin Good. We've got a Sabrina Cofield. And we got a... Krista Komondor.
Oh my goodness.
So let's
That's a
let's
lot start of meeting. Interesting sounding humans.
I know, and you can meet all these people at the party afterwards if you're a patron. So make sure you get over to our Patreon and sign up. All right. Give us the intro to the intro for Darin Good here.
Doop doop doobity dang a dang a doop 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 doobity doobity doop a doop doop doop. Doobity dang a dang a doop 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 doobity dang a zap doobity 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 doobity
He's got a big stash, and he's a lover of laugh. Please welcome to the show, Darin Good. Why, hello, Darin.
Wait, unmute yourself. Can you guys hear me?
We can. We certainly can. All
right. Hey, Stinky and Bunny.
It's great to see you. Great to have you on the show, Darin. Now, we introduced it. It says, you got a big stash, and you didn't let us down when you popped in.
Well, you know, this COVID, it's, what else do you do? You focus on growing your mustache.
That's right.
And beard.
I didn't. Well, I got some stubbly stuff here, but,
it's very Three Musketeers-esque.
Yes, I love it. I love it. It looks great. You look like a great person.
Stop it.
Yeah.
Oh, no. Really.
You look you're good. You're either really good with a sword or a paintbrush.
Yeah, Salvador Dali could be, actually. Yeah. It's like, there's been multiple comparisons, but I can't wait to get rid of it, man. It's like, I said, I'll just grow it until we go back to work. And we've been off work a little longer than I thought. So
you're really holding to that. You can't wait to get rid of it, but you are going to be true to your word.
But you're going to keep it.
No, as soon as I go back to work, it is gone. I can't.
It's gone. Word of warning. When you pull that thing off and throw it, it's got the right shape to come back to you, I think. Yeah. You want to be careful when it starts looping back.
Yeah, or starts inching away. I don't know.
Yeah, that too. Well, if it inches away, then job done, you know?
Yeah,
exactly. Problem solved.
Exactly.
So, Darin Good, you said, my suspenders came off in the back here and it caught on the chair.
Oh, boy.
Don't remind me not to stand up or else the pants are coming off. So, Darin Good, you said when you get back to work, right? What is the work? Because you said here, a lover of laugh. Now, is that, are you a laugh lover? Is that what you do for work there?
Yeah, well, that's my passion is laugh. Clowning. I dabble in the clown arts, you know.
Oh.
I've never been a professional clown, but I do work at a show called Ka, and I play a character there, which is very evil, manipulator. So it's kind of not
hysterical.
Yeah, it's kind of my passion is laugh. My job is to be an evil, manipulating character.
My goodness.
Oh, great!
Yeah,
excellent. Now, Darin, there's a lot of noise in the background. There's a lot of chicken there.
Yeah,
but where are you right now?
Well, I'm in my backyard, and because of this COVID situation, you know, like we started taking up hobbies, and one of the hobbies is raising chickens, and I can't take too much credit. My wife is actually the one that runs the organization of our little backyard chicken farming. So yeah, we've just been raising chickens kind of here. Let me like grab one of these little gaffers.
Oh my goodness.
Look at that cutie little chicken.
Is that an actual chicken?
That looks like,
it's a dark chicken. That chicken's
so this one actually hatched in an incubator. And so we got a couple more that are just growing and then we'll release them.
You release them to the
wild. You're gonna release them into the wild.
sorry, what was that?
You're releasing them into the wild to boost back up the Las Vegas chicken population.
Yeah. That's, I heard there was a need, but no, actually we just raise them and then we'll send them off, sell them or send them off to, you know, a loving family or whatnot. And but we keep about five or so, cause then we get eggs and it's a great little exchange. We'll raise you guys, give us some eggs.
Nice. Do you sell the eggs at all?
No, we've never sold them. We usually just, if there's an overflow, we'll give them to friends or whatever. And, oh, whoa,
so
oh, here's
oh
one.
My gosh.
Now that's more what I was expecting when I was expecting it to see a chicken. Is the
that's
kind of the
a
white
very Liberace chicken.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well,
look at that look chicken.
Now, do you name the chickens, or is that too hard when it comes time to have to part with them?
Oh no, we have names. That's part of my job. She takes care of the chickens. I'm more of quality control, like eating them and naming them. That's basically my part.
In that order?
Depending, yeah.
Okay.
Okay, so that's we got a Chick Jagger, we got a Conway Titty, we got Hugh, which is the rooster, and his partner Janus. Yeah, we've got a that's part of the fun of owning chickens is coming up with the names. And
I see. But yeah, I just assume like if you're actually gonna consume them as well, that you know, usually I don't know. It must be, you know, you wouldn't think you'd name them too, but.
Well, we actually don't eat them.
Oh. Oh. We
eat the eggs.
Oh, you eat the eggs. Okay.
So you eat their babies. Oh.
But depending how much longer being unemployed is, well, maybe we'll reevaluate that situation. So.
Okay. Because I was just thinking, how do you name, it's like your pets, right? And then you go, oh, who are we having for dinner tonight? Oh, this is Chick Jagger. You know, that must be a difficult thing. Yeah. So
you get over it pretty quickly. It's like, yeah.
I'm glad we cleared that up. Now this is an adult. Those other ones were younger ones. Now this is an adult.
This is Conway Tweety.
The
rare Edgar Allan Poe.
You see her.
Oh my gosh. I see it. I see the resemblance.
It becomes like a hobby, you know, like you start getting into like, oh, chickens are kind of cool, you know, like,
yeah,
different kinds. And
yeah,
they seem pretty chill.
Yeah, they usually, when you grab them, yeah, getting them, it's a little different story. But
so now those are both hens.
Yes.
So now do you have any roosters? Do you need any roosters around for the hens, or is that?
We have one. We have one.
We won't pick them up,
but we can't grab them. It's not.
They're more. So they're more. Roosters are more aggressive.
More aggressive and skittish.
Yeah.
Some people will jump up on our laps and sit down and like totally chill, and other ones will run away. But the rooster definitely is like no.
Yeah, it's toxic masculinity.
Yeah, that's what it is.
I just realized cockfighting was with roosters, and I spent a whole year of training wasted. So that's what it
learned. Well, I guess be happy you didn't get into the ring.
Yeah, exactly.
You could have had
that would have been embarrassing.
Yeah. Possibly painful.
Yeah.
Sure.
Darin, I gotta know. Everyone's asking on our chats right now. Are you any relation to Johnny B?
Johnny B. Good? I think that's like a great uncle or something. It could be.
I knew it.
Yeah. There might be some.
The chats have been blowing up about it this whole time. Stinky can attest.
I'm not seeing the same chat you are.
That, yeah.
But speaking of the chat though, ladies and gentlemen, please, if you have any questions, goodness, please use that chat. That's the whole thing. This show is an interdimensional show. So you're in your dimension, we're in ours, but that doesn't mean we can't talk. Okay. So go ahead and use those chats and because you know, who doesn't want to know more about backyard chickens in Las Vegas. Now, is this a common thing too in Vegas for people to have chickens in their backyard like that?
Well, we live in downtown area, and all our neighbors, you know, they all have chickens. Like
everybody's got chickens in downtown Vegas.
And when you put them up for sale, they're like during the pandemic, you couldn't even buy them at one point.
Oh my gosh. Now you trade, everybody you just trade them with your friends. It's like having Pokemon cards.
Yeah, no, we're just slinging chickens, you know, trading here and there.
I like the look of your chicken. I'll trade you this chicken.
Yeah. Yeah, it's exactly like that.
But that's an interesting point, though. Do you need to, because if you're hatching them yourself, do you not want any inbreeding happening? Do you need to kind of switch it out with other farmers?
Let me talk to the doctor over here.
All babies get sold. You don't want inbreeding.
All babies get sold. You don't want.
Oh, so all babies go somewhere else. So you don't have that problem with all the inbreeding.
How do you get the serial numbers on them so you know which ones are yours?
Well, we got a mini tattoo gun.
Perfect.
And,
yeah, you just shave them up. And... No, I'm joking.
We do have a question here for you, Darin Good.
The chats are lighting up.
Yeah, they're going crazy. Please ask your questions, ladies and gentlemen. Are roosters anything like foghorn leghorn?
If I knew what that was...
I'll say.
A foghorn what?
Foghorn leghorn. I do declare.
Absolutely.
Big Southern Looney Tunes chicken with a questionable history and a questionable past.
Mm-hmm.
Well, he walks around like he's the cock of the walk, but he's allowed. So I would say, kind of.
Okay, we have another question here for you, Darin Good. Now I know you have the chicken expert right across from you there, and she's answering some for you. And that's totally fine. But this is the question: do chickens fight bunnies?
No. I'm getting a shake of a head. No, I think they get along pretty good because our dogs and our chickens they all hang out together. They're perfectly fine. And...
Yeah, bunnies have a good history with chickens. It goes back pretty far.
Right back behind me is the chicken coop. And Bunny, that'd be a great Airbnb for you too.
Ah, that'd be sick. I'd love to come stay there. See, bunnies and chickens have a common enemy, the fox. And we have been working together for a very long time to stop foxes.
Yeah, and you both lay eggs, obviously.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, so that's a common bond.
That's right.
Yeah. Rabbits. Oh yeah, rabbits do lay eggs.
Yeah, every April or something like that.
Once a year we pop quite a few out. Some of them are chocolate. Some of them have that chocolate outside, but like cream on the inside that looks like an egg yolk. Those are real special bunnies that get that job done.
Yeah, those are the golden.
I come from a long line of jelly beaners.
Oh wow.
Yeah.
I wonder if we could breed like a chicken and a bunny and get some sort of crazy egg out of that.
I bet we could.
All right. Well, Bunny.
I'm not signing up for it. But I know some pretty twisted bunnies who would get down.
Yeah.
You got a donor. Hey, one last question here for you, Darin Good, because we got to go meet a couple other people. But your question from the chats here, do you ever ask them why they crossed the road? Is that something that you often ask those chickens?
I lay up at night thinking of that. And
why did
I sleep over it? And it's a tough one because we've never taken them to the road.
It's but a gamble.
Yeah. It's like, will they cross? I don't know. But we haven't come across that path, but I lay awake at night worrying about that.
I'm gonna get pulled now. But what can you do? Hey, Darin Good, it was a pleasure to talk to you. I hope you're able to shave off that mustache soon. I love it. Don't get me wrong, I love the mustache, but I know that, you know,
I hate it.
That you're back, you hate it, and you want to get back to work. So hopefully that thing comes off next time we see you. And thank you so much for showing us your chickens. This is the first time we've had dogs on the show.
Uh-huh.
I think we've had some cats, but never have we had chickens. So that's fantastic.
It's a big deal. Oh my goodness.
The dog pretty played out. And that's the rooster, the big white one. So.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Maybe if you're lucky.
All right.
Cool.
Thank you so much, Darin. Hey, but don't go anywhere. Here, cheers to you. What's in that mug of yours there? That fancy Vegas Theater Hub mug I see.
It is wine.
Oh,
that's yeah. A mug of wine.
Is that chicken wine? You making that out of chicken?
No.
Okay.
Just regular bunny wine.
Okay.
Bunny. Perfect. All right. Well, thank you so much, Darin. It's an absolute pleasure to talk to you. And like we said, we're going to bring you on at the end of the show for a panel discussion. So don't go anywhere. Or if it gets dark, feel free to go inside. Whatever you need to do. All right. That was Darin Good, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much. All right, buddy. It is time to meet our next guest. So do you want to give us the little intro to the intro here? Beautiful. She's an Emmy Award-winning journalist, a Vegas Valley Theater Award Best Supporting Actress winner, and is currently developing a short film and television series. Please welcome Sabrina Cofield.
Woo! Hi, guys.
Hello.
Hello.
Wow, it's great to have you on the show.
I'm very excited to be here.
Are you really?
I'm a huge fan.
Oh, whoa. My gosh.
You heard that, ladies and gentlemen. Stinky and Bunny may have not won an Emmy or been nominated or even come close.
Or to even being ever been thought of.
No, it's exactly. But we have fans out there that have won Emmys. That's the first thing that's, I think you might be our first Emmy Award winning guest. Really? So we'll start. Yeah.
I'm pretty sure.
I feel honored. Pretty sure. Yeah. He's like, oh, no, I'm pretty sure that's the first.
Yeah. I'm pretty safe. I think
you have a different assumption. You have a different air about you than our typical guest.
Yeah.
What does that mean?
It means you've got the look of someone who has an Emmy.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
You got it together.
I'll take that as a compliment. Thank you.
No offense to Darin Good, but that's not an Emmy award-winning mustache he's wielding.
Yeah.
You never know.
You never know. He may get one someday. He may have one. Maybe we'll have to ask our guest now. From now on, do you?
You should put that on. You should make that a standard question. You might be surprised.
Yeah, for sure.
Are you
that most people
are
have Emmys?
You in possession of an Emmy award?
Yes.
And the follow up is: did you win it, or did you take it from somebody else?
Or did you steal it, or did you get it?
Steal.
Buy it at an auction.
Did you buy it? Did you buy it in an estate sale?
Right.
So it's Sabrina.
Yes.
The thing is, this is burning me. This is a question that's kind of going, oh, I need to know. So you're an Emmy Award winning journalist. So what exactly did you win the Emmy for? what'd you do?
So I used to be a reporter and producer in Atlanta. And so it was for the 6 o'clock. I don't even know what show it was for. CBS News Atlanta. I don't know if it was for the 5 o'clock or 6 o'clock show, but it was for a show that we did there.
Wow.
Your answer. But yeah.
But I guess that happens, right? Someone wins an Emmy and they're like, I don't know. I can't remember.
I'm a lot older than I look. So it was a really long time ago. It was in 2000. I am old. Oh my god.
You won an Emmy in the year 2000? Right, you won a Y2 Emmy?
I should be quiet. Huh?
You won a Y2 Emmy?
I won a Y2 Emmy.
That's what they called them that year, right?
That's what they used to call them.
That is what they called them that year. It's actually a really special year to win one. So
your Emmy can officially go out and buy a drink.
Yeah. That is true.
Little
that
Emmy.
Is true.
But
if somebody won an Emmy and their name was Emmy, would they be impossible to talk to for the rest of their life?
I think so, because I think it would just come up in conversation, right? Like, no, it's like, Emmy. You know, like,
oh, I won an Emmy. Oh, you're talking to me or to my award that I won for my work? Me. Oh, yeah.
Oh, that was for me. Okay. Are you sure it wasn't? Yeah.
No, I mean, I don't think they named it after me, but. Who can say?
Yeah. So that's eight. Hey, What I need to know this, because okay, if I were to win something, or if I someone okay, one person did something special for me here. Ruben Permel painted. Oh, here it is. Painted a portrait. It is
incredible, by the way.
Right there. And so yeah, so I display that behind me. As kind of like a hey, someone thought I was important enough to paint a portrait and put it up in a gallery, but really then awesome. just sent it to me anyway. But you know, that's behind me because it's like, hey, this is cool. So I'd expect just to see an Emmy behind you. Like I would be on Zoom all the time going, oh, look at this thing.
Yeah.
So where is this? Where is this Emmy of yours?
I don't have it. My mom has it. The funny thing too is I actually never even mention it or tell anybody that I won it because it was in 2000. Clearly, it was a very long time ago. But I have a girlfriend, Adia, who tells everyone. And so she finally was like, you should probably mention that and tell people. So it's kind of like my running joke of like, tell me something I don't know about you. And I'm like, I won an Emmy Award. But no, I don't have it. I have a framed certificate saying it, but actually the award is at my parents' house.
If you think your mom isn't taking probably in the bathroom to the bank,
it's like a door
to the grocery store, everywhere she goes, she's like, oh, this, my daughter won an Emmy.
Yeah, I don't think so.
If I had an Emmy, I would make a necklace out of it. I would put a rope around it, hang it from my neck, and I would get used to saying, oh, this old thing.
Yeah.
This
is nothing.
This, yes, this it is an Emmy.
21 years.
Oh my gosh, how cute of you to notice. It is an Emmy.
I know. Yeah. Anyway.
So,
yeah.
But that. Okay, but this is the thing. Hey, that was great, the Emmy. Congratulations. But also, you mentioned here that a Vegas Valley Theater Award Best Supporting Actress winner as well.
Yeah.
So congratulations on that.
You had me give you all these things. I mean, I could have said I run. I don't know what could I have said. I love everything with coconut on it. I don't know. That's not interesting.
Oh, yeah, that would have been a better talking point, but whatever.
Let's talk about that then. I'm like, I don't want to talk about like.
No, I just want to bring it up. Because it's just like, we'll get to the coconut. I just want to say, what do you feel better about, the Emmy or the Vegas Valley Theater Award? Like, are they both like, oh.
That's a really great question. That's a really good question. Nobody's ever asked me that before.
Well, maybe because you don't tell anybody about the Emmy.
That's a good point.
I feel like I have to say.
Please do.
I think that you are the type of person who should be running for office. The type office of person
what?
Who wins an Emmy and is like, I don't really want to talk about it. No big deal. It's not a big deal.
Well, this is what's interesting. So him asking me that question is interesting, right? Because I love being an actor. I love being on stage. I love telling beautiful stories. So my heart wants to say, oh, the Vegas Theater Award. I mean, but let's be honest. I love Vegas. I love theater, but it's no Emmy, right?
And they didn't give you a statue. Did they give you a statue?
But, no, I got a plaque.
Okay.
So.
Plaque and a statue, so, I mean, everybody.
Right, exactly. You get it for anything. So I love the Emmy, but news was tough and I got out of it after so many years. I can't say because I'm already showing my age by saying I went in 2000. You know, news is a special kind of beast, and I didn't love it. So there's something with that, but it's a freaking Emmy, and I know that. And so that's an interesting question.
Oh.
I don't know the. I gotta say the Emmy because it's an Emmy, but
yeah.
Which one? Wait. You're on a boat. You're fishing.
Yeah. I'm saving the Emmy. I'm saving the Emmy.
You're sport fishing, and you've brought your plaque and your
I'm
Emmy.
Saving the Emmy because the Emmy can get me a job if I ever get back to land and I really need a job. I think the Emmy's going to have me a job than the Vegas Theater Award. I'm just saying. So I'll keep the Emmy.
No offense. Also, if it's a plaque Vegas on wood, it might float.
Good point.
So you get that later. You go back for that.
All right, you heard it here, Vegas Valley Theater Award. You're going overboard. All right. So, but hold on. You're doing stuff now, which is good. You are developing a short film and television series. Now, is it a short film and television series? It's like,
yeah. So there's two. Old. Yeah, there's two different things. So we've all been quarantined, and I've been doing a lot of writing. Because what else are you going to do when you're stuck in your house? And yeah, so there's been a lot of writing going on with lots of friends, and so we've got a TV series that we're working on that is incredible, and a short film that we're working on that was actually in the Fringe Festival, so it was a play that we did, and then we're now turning it into a short film. So yeah. So
oh my gosh.
Yeah.
That's amazing.
It'll be fun. Maybe Stinky and Bunny can make a cameo.
Oh my goodness.
That would be fun. Wouldn't that be fun? It would be.
We'd do it.
Oh yeah.
Are you guys expensive? Like
you send it. You're as expensive as you can afford.
Okay. How many bottle caps have you saved?
There's been a lot of drinking in quarantine. I've had a lot of bottle caps.
We're quite a few bottle caps.
Oh, okay. Okay. Yeah.
Oh, wow. I'm excited about that. This is pretty exciting. We got the apparel show coming up this weekend.
Uh-huh.
And you heard it here that we're going to be part of a Sabrina Cofield show.
An Emmy Award-winning TV show.
I'm telling you guys, it's a matter of time. You've got fans, right? You've got fans.
Oh, yeah.
Soon I'm going to be like begging to be on the show. There's going to be like a long line of people. I'm going to be like, hello, remember me with the Emmy? And you guys are going to be like.
We're going to be like, how many Emmys do you have?
Right. Do you only have one? Because that's not going to make the cut.
Is that why you started writing a TV show? Did your mom say, like, the books are falling down on the other side of the bookshelf?
Right, right.
I need another Emmy.
Like, this isn't working anymore. This is bragging. Everybody's already heard this story. I need double Emmys or nothing. I need something else to brag about. This is so old. This isn't working anymore. Yeah.
What's the thing where you win them all? What's that one called?
Oh, and what is it? EGOT? No, what is it? Yeah.
EGOT. Like Emmy, Grammy.
Grammy, Tony.
Oscar, Tony.
Oscar, Tony.
You're on your way to an EGOT.
I am.
One step closer than most of
them. I only need three more. Three of the four.
Yeah.
I'm well on my way.
You're well on your way to an EGOT.
I wonder if the Vegas Valley Theater Award could like kind of slide in like where Tony would go, right?
You got an EGOV. You got the E and the V.
I have the E and the V, so I only need two more. All right.
Yeah.
Working on it.
It could happen. It could happen.
You know what? It could happen.
I'm excited for this. Sure. I think it's good. I feel it. I know it. And now that you're on our show, and there's tens and tens of people that are watching this right now.
My phone is ringing right now with like offers and agents because there's
how come ours, yeah. ours never did. Anyway, you know what, Sabrina? It was incredible to talk to you, especially, you know, you're, as we said, our first Emmy Award winning guest.
I'm honored you have that title. Thank you.
No, we have. I just thought we had another guest on our show before that actually won something called the Juno Award.
What is that?
That is the Canadian equivalent of an Emmy.
Really?
So, yeah. So now we have awesome. Juno and an Emmy.
What?
So,
what did they do to win the Juno? Like, what was their?
He's a writer. But you know what? It's funny.
That's incredible.
Because he's Canadian. He's a Canadian that won an award, so it never came up. It never came up in a conversation.
I love that.
I've heard that the exchange rate, you can switch that for the Grammy and have an EGOT.
So Sabrina, it was such a pleasure to talk to you. It's great to meet you, and hopefully, please beg us to be on the show again.
Thank you. And then you guys can come on, be in my film, and then we'll be big.
Happily.
Yeah.
We are very good at being dead bodies. We are very good at being guy yelling in the grocery store. Oh. We're very good at being people digging in a trash can as the camera pans over.
I love it.
We're good at, you know, all what of
I can do this one. You went that way.
Oh, okay. Very good. I love it. It's perfect.
You went that way. That's a good, that's my, I've been working on that for that's a long time. A lot of movies need that. It's like, where'd it go?
Very grounded. It was really beautiful. Yeah.
Oh, thank you. Yeah. I've been, like I said, I've been working on it. So it's like, it comes to me like that, just like that. It's like people can cry.
I'll give you a good, you've been right in front of me all along.
Oh, it's a love story.
Oh.
Oh, see, I knew there, I was feeling there was something.
It's a romantic comedy. It started out as something else, but.
And then it just switched
to romantic comedy.
I love it. I feel it.
Well, Sabrina, like I said, it was great to talk to you. But the thing is, we got to get to it. We got to get.
Yeah, you got to go. You have other people.
Yeah. I know. We have a guest, another guest, but don't go anywhere. Like I said, like stay with Darin. Good. Oh, do you have a drink with you, Sabrina?
Yes, I do. Yep. Cheers.
What are you drinking? Oh, look at that thing.
I'm drinking a strawberry banana juice.
Cheers. That's
pretty good.
All right, Sabrina, great to talk to you. We'll see you at the end of the show with you can drink some more of your banana strawberry juice.
I know. Okay.
Thank you so much. It was great to talk to you. Bunny, all right, give me the intro to the intro music for our next guest.
Blah, blah, blah. Blah, blah, blah. Blah, blah, blah. Do, 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 do. Blah, blah, blah. Blah, blah, blah. Wow, 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 wow. That was pretty good.
Oh. Ooh. Nice. Oh, she's adding her own bit to the end. Perfect. She's a comedian and recovering nurse practitioner living in Williamsburg, Brooklyn. Please welcome to the show, everybody, Krista Komondor.
Woo!
Hey.
Hello.
How you? It's great to have you on the show. I think you're our first guest from Williamsburg, Brooklyn.
It's the hippest neighborhood in the country. Ooh.
Oh my gosh.
I didn't know that.
That's what they say, the people who live here, I guess.
Oh, it's just the people that live there say that.
Yeah.
Yeah, I see. So, Christine, I see is that the French flag behind you?
It is. It is the French flag.
Okay.
They're actually... They're actually sheets.
It's beautiful. Oh, okay.
I can hide behind it.
Oh my gosh.
Oh wow, look at that. Oh,
it's so lovely. It looks like the set of Les Mis before things went to hell.
It's kind of like that. I have a show that I do and it's like, it's a mess after I finish. So it's kind of like, it's good to hear that I'm not the first one.
Well, let's start there. What is this show that you do?
It's called Sexpert Madam K, and I run the whole show out of my apartment. It's insane. I have spotlights. I don't have them queued right now, but I have a 400 square foot apartment where I have spotlights and I change my voice, and it's a clown show, and I throw bananas, and there are all these.
Oh my goodness.
They're all these chickens with eyes. And my house is a mess after I finish. It's just, there's water everywhere.
Wait a minute.
Now, do you have union people working on those spots?
Oh no.
They're just climbing up your wall. And...
They're just, they're on a bookshelf.
Okay.
Oh, okay. No, but you mentioned the thing that stuck out to me was this chickens thing. So do you have chickens in your apartment?
Well, no, I have romance items.
Romance.
Oh. You might say. Yeah.
Romance
tools. Romantic tools. For romantic. A solo or a couple or a three like a four.
Like a vase full of roses and
no, they're actually, here's like, can I introduce you, sweetie pie? You want to come out?
Wait. Oh, you have someone there with you?
I do. Yeah, I have. He's my little friend. He's
okay. Oh, hello. What's your friend's name?
His name is Diesel. He's very shy, though. He's very shy. Sweetie pie.
Oh, Diesel.
Honey, he can see your little head. He can see your little head. He's very shy. We'll have a little snack later, okay? You want a little snack? Okay. You like his little shirt?
It's beautiful.
Oh, it is. It's very nice.
I made it myself. It's a custom fit.
Oh, wow. I imagine it's hard to find clothes for Diesel.
It's tricky. I have like 9 of them in my house.
Nine Diesels?
Yeah. 9 little friends.
Oh, okay.
Great. The guy I used to date, I think he had an issue with them.
Oh, yeah?
Well, he didn't know you had kids.
He didn't know I had all these animals.
Yeah.
All these pets.
Yeah, for sure. Now, since you're a comedian, which, of course, we can see that, but a recovering nurse practitioner. How do you recover from that?
Oh, it's really traumatizing. That's why. Yeah. I used to work in nursing homes. I used to do end of life stuff. Very exciting. This is really funny stuff. Just really intense, dramatic kind of stuff. And then I just couldn't do it anymore. It was too much.
It sounds hard. It sounds really difficult.
It was really difficult. Yeah. It was really
so that's difficult. When you decided to go, hey, I'm going to, me and Diesel here, we're going to put a show up.
There's a little bit between the two. Yeah. I had to learn that I was a comedian. I had no idea.
Oh, so how did that come about? Did you just all of a sudden, you know, there was a mic at a karaoke and you said a joke and it worked, or how did that come about?
I started taking a memoir class with all these widows. Like their husbands had just died. And I think their therapist told them to take a memoir writing class to like purge it. Right.
Yeah.
So I was reading these crazy, like sex stories of like just crazy stuff. It was really funny. And my teacher, who was this lovely guy, he's like, you have chutzpah. You should do stand up. And I'm really good at taking suggestions. So I got up on stage and I became really addicted to it. It's a lot of adrenaline. So, and you know, you bomb for a while and then you get a little laugh. You hear like one person laugh and then get excited. And it's just, it's intense. I used to do it like every night of the week. The quarantine was actually kind of nice because it was like, there was no pressure to get out there and get up on stage.
Well, yeah. Well, you could. Right. That always takes the pressure off when you can't do something.
Yeah.
But are you now, is there any sign of any, you coming back on stage now, or is it still at that stage or out there?
You know, people are, I streamed this show out of my house. I did Edinburgh last year, virtual, and I did like 27 live shows and now I have this great video that I put online that I just did the Pittsburgh Fringe. I did the Oregon Fringe. And so it's really nice because people buy tickets to it and I don't have to go anywhere.
Yeah.
And I've really
So people buy tickets for things online then?
It's hard to believe they do. Yeah.
So we can be selling tickets to our show right now.
You could.
I don't know if we're the same caliber.
Well, okay. You know, I put it on Eventbrite and people will just drop in.
All right. Well, we'll do that. Eventbrite. We'll do Eventbrite. Okay.
I used to do it on Twitch where all these like 20 something like virgins who play video games all day would comment and they would show up on the screen. And so that
they have really a lot fun. To say.
They have a lot to say. They said the 19th Amendment should be repealed, which is a woman's right to vote.
Classic virgin talk.
Classic virgin talk.
That's a virgin.
It's a total virgin. But it's interesting because I used to do this. I have another character who's more of a sexy. She's not the clown. She's like Madame Komondor and she's French. And I did her in Edinburgh in 2019. And she's like, she gives love advice. And when I would do her on the show, all these kids would do her on the show. All these kids would get on, kids like 20 somethings, and they would want to know, they're like, am I a normal size? They would just ask a lot of questions about sex and being a nurse practitioner. So I have that background of knowledge of anatomy and knowledge of all this stuff. So I'd be able to like educate them. So that was actually really fun.
Wow. Nice. You know what? We have our shows on, if anybody's out there watching us on Twitch, I don't know if anybody's out there. People don't tend to. Oh, no, we do. We have Kersixels watching us out there. There's six of us watching us out there on Twitch. But yeah, we're on the Twitchers too right now.
We are. Don't have, ooh, exciting.
Yeah, and we have nobody out there writing us about their penis size. But that's okay. We don't
need
to know.
If you show one of these, you'll get like, you'll get a landslide.
Okay. Great. Well, maybe we should introduce. Maybe Diesel can be. Maybe it can be.
If you're in the chats right now and you want to start dropping sizes in the chats, just send them on through.
Yeah.
Send them on through.
We don't want any pics, but we'll take your sizes.
Yeah. No pics. No pics. Thank you very much.
You send us a number. You don't even tell us what you're measuring. You just send us some numbers. We'll take them.
There you go. Okay. We got one. We got one here. We got the classic. What's that called? An eggplant here. Looks good. Looks good to me.
I'm really impressed. They put an eggplant in the chat?
Yeah, we got an eggplant in the chat. So I guess that's an eggplant fan.
They're paying attention. So
there you go. There you go. So how are things? So Brooklyn too, right? Now Williamsburg, Brooklyn. So is that the Brooklyn I know? Is that a part of Brooklyn?
It's really fancy. It's like the Soho of Brooklyn.
Soho of Brooklyn. Okay. I think I know what that means. Okay. Wow. So is it now when you're doing your stand-ups, is that in like the New York area mostly, or do you just kind of go, I do Brooklyn?
Oh yeah. I do all over New York City. I even was on Staten Island, which is bizarre. And then I was in France doing it. I was in England doing it a little bit. And then, of course, the UK. But mostly it's in, when I'm here in the city, it's in New York City. Usually okay. Like the East Village or the Upper West Side.
So now you said that you're doing a few things. Like you got your show, the online show. Now, do you have anything coming up at all? Is there anything coming up for you?
Yeah, I actually have Sexpert Madam K. It's on Eventbrite right now. It's video on demand. And It'll be up till the end of the month.
Great. And you know what? I think we have a link to that, to information on that. If you're out there on the Facebooks and the YouTubes, you can go ahead and click on that link and I imagine learn more, right? So go ahead and go in out and support. That'd be fantastic. Now, Are you at all, so comedian, recovering nurse practitioner, are you at all musically inclined?
I am. Actually, in quarantine, I bought a bass guitar, an electric guitar, and a ukulele. I learned how to play.
Like a one-woman band type of thing? Do you play all three at the same time?
I also have one of these, and I have the little egg shakers, which look like, you know, male parts if you put two of them together. So the chicken guy might like these.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. Well, I imagine he's going crazy right now.
Do you have any of these?
I have this thing today.
No way. That's so cool. That's perfect.
The thing is, I have a ukulele myself. I do. That's how I introduce the show every day. And this is the first time in 54 shows that I don't have my ukulele.
Oh no.
So I can play the show is missing. What I'm saying is this show is missing a ukulele right now.
Oh, yeah.
It is sad. What it is.
Is it a soprano? Yeah. What kind is it? Is it sure. Teeny, little tiny?
Yeah. Yeah. It's a soprano. It's a soprano ukulele. What kind of ukulele do you have?
I have a concert ukulele. So it's the middle size.
Oh.
Yeah. That's a little bigger than yours.
Oh, okay. Well, I've heard that before. I've heard that many times before. But hey, do you can you play us something?
I can. I started learning to play the bolero actually because I stopped. I'm trying to decrease my screen time on my phone. So instead of grabbing my phone, I'm learning this really complicated song, which I don't know if I can play it because I've never played it in front of people, but I can try. Okay. I'm really nervous. I'm having performance anxiety.
Oh, that's, you know what?
It was sounding beautiful.
Oh, thank you. Yeah. Thank you. I have like 20 measures memorized, but I've never played in front of people before. So.
Yeah. Oh, well, there's people out there. But no, that was great, but really it's like no pressure at all. For sure. That was what I heard there sounded. That was more than I play. I think I know 3 chords myself.
Oh, cool. I had a song called My Monkey Is in the Oven. It's like a clown song.
Oh, okay. Because I was wondering if it was a serious song, My Monkey's in the Oven.
My Monkey's in the Oven.
Concerned about that.
Yeah.
For sure. Wow. Krista, it's been wonderful to talk to you. Now you did do the Edinburgh. Now how was the Edinburgh? You did the Edinburgh online, right? Because the Edinburgh, really, I don't know, the Edinburgh Fringe Festival, I think is the biggest, one of the biggest festivals out there, right?
I went there in 2019, and there were over 4,000 shows to compete with, and it's a great way to feel like you're not enough. A friend of mine described it as like carrying every day. It's like carrying your cross up the hill. because you go out and you have flyers. And I had this sign that said better erections in 1 minute. And I would hold it out in the street. I would hold out this sign. I had my lab coat on and my red lipstick, and I had a little prescription pad. So I would engage people in conversation and just ask them questions like, what kind of cereal do you like? And this and that. I'd be like, oh, you really need help here. You should come to my show tonight with the prescription pad. So the first night, the only person there was my PR person. She really sucked because she was the only person there.
Oh, God.
But one night I had a stag party that I'd barked in. And everyone was really concerned that they were going to like bust up the place, but they were really fun. As soon as the show starts, I say, I'm a specialist in men's health, and I grab a guy out of the audience. And then I put a large a magnum sized condom on my hand, and I use it as a puppet in their face. And I ask them what kind of porn they're like. It's a really fun show.
Sounds like it's right up. Right up my alley, as they say.
Yeah, I haven't done it. I should do it again. It was fun.
Yeah, for sure. That's the thing. Like a festival like that, it's a lot of competition. It's tough to get people out for sure. Yeah. But good on you for doing it for sure. We said we'll let us know if you're ever in doing anything near Laughlin, Nevada.
You know, I've been thinking about going there. I have a friend who's out there. And,
oh, yeah?
Yeah. Yeah.
Great. Well, let us know.
I've never been there, though.
Bunny, we got the couch here. She can stay on.
Yeah. We got the couch. It's not made to be a fold-out, but it is a fold-out.
Is it good and lumpy?
We can make it
fold. I like it lumpy.
Yeah. If you pretty hit lumpy. It in the right place on the side, it turns into a fold-out.
Yeah. Exactly. Very nice.
Only the best for your guests, I see.
And it's a bit of an angle. So, but if you get your head facing the right way, you won't roll off of it.
Yeah.
So, okay. It should be all right. It'll be great. We'll definitely welcome you with open arms. Krista, you know, it was fantastic talking to you. Such a good time.
It's great talking to you too.
Well, and we should, yeah, let us know when you're in town and we'll hook you up for sure.
Oh, yeah.
Excellent.
But Krista, we're going to, you're not going, don't go anywhere. Oh, do you have a drink with you,
Krista? I won't go anywhere. I do.
What are you drinking?
Coffee.
Oh, a coffee. Cheers to you. Cheers. You're drinking coffee. What time is it where you're at?
It's like 11 o'clock.
Oh, drinking coffee. Good time. Great time. Do what
it's
you
decaf.
Do. Oh, okay. Decaf. Great. Great.
I only drink decaf.
No, great. So great to talk to you. But now it's time, of course, to bring our panel, ladies and gentlemen, for our question of the day. So please welcome back to the show, Darin and Sabrina. Darin and Sabrina.
Woo! Woo! Yay! Woo! Welcome back.
All right. Are we all here? Are we out there, Sabrina? Oh, there they are. Great. So now it is time for our... There's Darin. So now it is time for our question of the day. Bunny, go ahead and give me the question of the day. Question of the day music.
Question of the day. Toot, toot. Question of the day. Boop, boop.
Question.
He's going to ask it. You're going to answer it. Question of the day.
Woo. Oh, look. I wrote the Eventbrite information on the question of the day card. Saving paper. Okay, here it is. The question of the day. What would be your wrestling intro music? Oh, look at that. You're entering the ring, walking down the aisle. What's that music that we hear playing to pump you up and to pump the crowd up? Darin, good. What song do you have playing in the arena?
I mean, that's a tough one because I've been dreaming about this for years.
Oh, yeah.
I actually walk down and like have somebody say, coming out of this corner, weighing 125, does not like to be punched in the head, is very susceptible to concussions, or something tough, fireworks going off, and da 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 da, and then tiptoe through the tulips. I think that would be, you know.
Ah.
That
classic. That'd be a good one.
Yeah.
That'd be a classic.
Just kind of like fake the.
Very good.
Yeah, I don't know. I just always thought that would be kind of.
That is kind of a music to pump you up for sure. You know what? Maybe you can talk to Krista there because she plays the ukulele.
And that was my other thing. I was like, either that or Krista's song.
Oh, yes. We could, yeah, for sure.
I changed my mind throughout the interview.
She could follow you out and you come down the ramp with her. With a concert ukulele.
Concert. Yeah.
And she could double as your manager too, I'm sure.
Yeah, or yeah, absolutely. Let's talk after, Krista.
He looks like a tough dude.
Yeah. At the after party, for sure. At the after party, you two talk. And please, ladies and gentlemen, sign up to be our patron and be at our after party because we'd love to see you there. So what about you, Sabrina? What would be your intro music?
You know, I'm sitting here trying to think of something. I'm like, I don't know what it would be. So I'm assuming it has to be something by Rihanna or Beyonce, just because, I mean, I feel like that would work. So mm-hmm. I'm going to go with, can I say a curse word on here? Is that bad?
Oh, yeah.
I feel like Bitch Better Have My Money by Rihanna would be the song.
That's pretty good. There you go.
Walk out too. So that's what I'm going to go with. Yeah.
I think that suits you. I think that suits you. You walking out there with that song playing, Emmy in one hand, Vegas Valley Theater Award in the other. Boom. Yeah. I see that.
No one in the history of wrestling has ever been clobbered with an Emmy. I think that would be.
And then I would be like, pay me.
You would get an Emmy for hitting somebody with an Emmy.
Wait, does no.
Show's over. Easy win.
Now, does The Rock, does he have an award? No, he wouldn't have an Emmy.
No.
Oscar.
No.
I'm just kidding.
No.
I'm totally joking.
He might. I don't know what he. I don't know if he has any of the EGOTs.
No, I don't think so either. I don't see that happening. I love him. If you want to be on the show, I'm sure he's watching. If you want to be on the show, though, please.
Yeah.
You that we don't have the credentials. You just want to.
If Dwayne The Rock Johnson is watching and he wants an EGOT, you just got to go. You start with Stephen Sondheim. You turn him upside down and shake him. A couple of those Tonys will come right out of his pockets.
That is true.
You grab there one you go. Of those Tonys.
Get so, down your so Krista, what would be your entrance music?
Oh, I actually have it. Can I play it?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Is it playing now, Krista? Krista, we can't hear it at all.
Shit, you can't hear it. I'm sorry.
We couldn't hear it, or you.
It's in her head.
We felt it though.
Oh, you couldn't hear it. It's Love Machine.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, there it is. That's straight. Can you hold it up to the mic, maybe?
Oh yeah, I'll hold it.
There we go.
Oh, there we go.
That's an awfully sweet song to walk out to a wrestling match to.
Yeah.
I would.
Yeah, but
it's like, hopeful. It's like we might be enemies.
We could be friends after that.
I wouldn't mess with that. I would definitely.
No. You'd be like, there's something weird about this.
I've actually used it as my entrance music because I used to walk on stage with a big, you know, squirting thing and I would squirt the crowd with it.
Squirting thing. Nice. That's perfect. But I'd love to see like Darin Good with his Tiptoe Through the Tulips versus Love Machine. That sounds like that's just pump crowd up right there. Buddy, we're over time. So thank you everybody that stuck with us. Buddy, what would be your entrance music?
I think I would do the Entertainer. But I would let it play out the whole thing. Like,
oh yeah?
It would play the whole thing and I would just have a backpack full of steel chairs. And as I'm coming down the ramp, I'm just whopping fans with steel chairs one after another.
Wow, that's a great one. I was thinking I might do Muffin Man. You know that?
Uh-huh. Never heard that song.
Does anybody know the Muffin Man? Is that how it goes? Yeah, and I pass out, and I'd be like you though with the steel chairs, except I'd be handing out muffins on my way up. I think that would be pretty cool. I don't think any wrestlers passed out muffins before.
No, I don't think so.
I think that's pretty hardcore. So, ladies and gentlemen, it's getting late. It's time to wrap up our show. Thank you so much to everybody that came to watch us here today and participated in the chats. It's great to see you all on coming out here on this Tuesday. I'd like to thank our patrons. Our patrons, of course, support the show. Without you, we wouldn't be able to afford our internet bills. So thank you so much to our sponsors for today, which is Kristen Cooper, Tanya McIntosh, and Adam Van Dremel. So hope to see some of you at the after party tonight. Like I said, patreon.com/stinkingbunny. If you want to support the show, we'd love to have you. We can always use more. And let's thank our guests for today. Thank you very much, Darin Good.
Woo!
Thanks for having me, guys. That's awesome. Great honor to be on here.
Thank you so much, Sabrina Cofield.
Yay. Woo!
Thanks for having me. Tons of fun.
And thank you so much to Krista Komondor.
Woo!
Woo-hoo!
It's a great lineup as always. So thank you so much. And thank you everybody for coming out. And we'll see you again next Tuesday. Bye-bye, everybody.
Bye.
Take care, guys.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.